Hi everyone, thanks for watching 3dmotive.com. My name is Mike, and in this video we'll be showing you how to import a mesh into UDK from 3ds Max 2010. This tutorial is intended for a beginner level. So let's start off by having our object you want to import into UDK open in Max, because there's a few things that we need to do before we actually export. First thing we're going to do is look at the pivot point of your object. If I click on my object, you'll notice that pivot point is way off to the left side of the object. We really want it the bottommost part of the mesh. So we're going to go up to the Hierarchy tab and click Effect Pivot Only button. This will allow you to move the pivot around without actually moving the object itself. So we'll center the object, go to the front viewport, and we want to align the pivot to the mesh. You'll notice that it brings up the Align Selection toolbox with a few default settings. We want to center out the current object and put the target object to minimum. And then check off X and Z position, because we only want the Y position. And you'll notice that the pivot moved down to the bottommost part of the prop. I'm going to click OK and click off of Effect Pivot Only. Now we want to center the object to world space in Max. You need to do this because if we export now, our pivot will show up in the wrong place in Unreal. So I'm going to go ahead and show the grid by pressing the G key. And we'll go up here and right click on the Move button. We want to zero all these out so it's centered in world space. So just go ahead and right click on the spinners, and you can see that the TV is now centered in world space. Alright, and there's one last thing we need to do before we export, and that's reset X-forms. What reset X-form basically does is it removes all rotation and scale values from your object. So it's a really good habit to get into, if you attach or scale your object or anything like that, it will basically just reset all transformations. So to get to the Reset X Form, you want to go up to the Utilities tab up here in the right corner, click on Reset X Form, and then Reset Selected. You'll notice if you go back to your modifier list, it added an X Form modifier here. We'll go ahead and collapse stack by right-clicking Collapse All, and then Yes. Alright, and now your object is ready to export into Unreal. So make sure you have your object selected, and we'll go up to the File menu, Export, Export Selected. I'm going to go ahead and give our asset a name. Name them Television Set. Score Stat. And I'm going to go down and select the .ASE format, which Unreal recognizes. I click Save. And you'll notice that the .ASE exporter dialog box comes up with a bunch of default checkboxes. These are the ones that we want checked on. We don't need any of the other stuff. And the nice thing about this, if you do this once, Max will save your settings, so every time you export an object, it'll have the same settings. So we'll go ahead and click OK. And now our object is exported. Let's go ahead and bring up Unreal. We want to create a package for our object. So go ahead and click Import, and we'll find our .ASE file that we just saved out, our export folder. We'll open that up. And we'll name give the package something we'll recognize. I'm going to name it prop underscore television set. And since it's the mesh that we're importing, I'm going to create a meshes group for this. And click OK. And you'll notice this created the package. So pretty much every time you import an object into Unreal, the thumbnail angle isn't going to be that great. So if you double click and open up the static mesh editor, we'll rotate the camera around the mesh a bit, and we'll click the Save Thumbnail Angle button. And what this will do is it'll save the thumbnail angle for you. Makes it easier to see in the package. So as with everything, it's always really important to save as often as you can. So I'm going to right-click on the package and save. I'm going to save it to the Environments folder under the UT Game directory. As a UPK. If you save it to the environments folder, it should, every time you open Unreal, it should load the package automatically. So we'll go ahead and save that. Now we'll want to import the textures for this asset. So click on Import, and we'll browse to our texture folder. And I'm just going to import the color and the specular map for now. I'm going to create a textures group. Click OK to all. Okay, so you see that put both textures in the textures group. I'll go ahead and save our package. And click back on textures, and we'll import our normal map. The reason why I import the normal map separate is because it requires different compression settings. So I'll still put it in the textures group, but down here under compression settings, click TC underscore normal map, and click OK. Alright, so the last thing we want to do is create a material for our object. So if you right-click in the content browser, we'll select New Material. And we'll name this material Television Set underscore mat for material. And we'll want to change the group to Materials and click OK. And the Material Editor will pop up here. And so now what we want to do is we want to get our textures into the material itself. So to do that, you want to go over to the material expressions and we want to find texture sample. Click and drag over to the workspace. And then we'll want to go back to our content browser and select our color map. Back to the material. And we'll want to plug the color map into this texture sample node. And drag the arrow over to the diffuse slot. And you'll notice that now our color map is now applied to our material. We'll go ahead and save this. Go back to the content browser and grab our specular map. Now there's a shortcut. If you hold down T and click, a texture sample node will automatically pop up in the workspace. Notice also that the specular map is included in this texture sample as well. That's because we had the specular map selected in the content browser. So we'll plug this into the specular slot here, and you'll notice now we have specular on our material. Grab the normal map, go back to the material, press T. Now our normal map is in the texture sample, and we'll add this to the normal slot. And now our material has a normal map. Alright, we'll save the material. And we'll close it. Now we want to apply the material to the mesh. So we'll double click and open up the static mesh editor. And we'll right click the LOD info to expand it all the way. And we'll want to find our material and plug it into the material slot here. And there we have it. Our material is successfully applied to our mesh. This concludes our lesson. If you have any issues with the steps we covered in this lesson, please don't hesitate to post on our forums. Be sure to check out our other videos, and thanks for watching 3dmotive.com.